Magandang buhay! This is Teacher Melody M. Valiente, and I welcome you to Week 3 of Quarter 1 in Physical Education and Health for Grade 11. So, this lesson is entitled Moderate to Vigorous Physical Activities. And we would like to thank Sir Floyd Victor Tipay and Ma'am Hazel V. Corpus for writing this activity sheets. Okay, so I expect na hawak nyo na ang inyong learning activity sheets by now para makasabay kayo sa ating discussion. Alright, so the learning competency for this engages in moderate to vigorous physical activities for at least 60 minutes most days of the week in a variety of settings, in and out of school. Sana magawa natin to, no? Kahit ako, at least 60 minutes most days of the week. Pwedeng sa loob ng bahay, pwedeng sa bakuran, wag lang sa kapitbahay, wag din sa court o sa plaza, no? Maraming settings o place kung paano o saan tayo mag-exercise or gagawa ng mga physical activities na to. Okay, so for background information, so, you know, physical activity is a part of the human life. Yes, every day we face a lot of physical activities, whether it is tiring or relaxing. So, most of the time, we are not aware that the things we do, just like sitting in a chair or while you're in a computer, it's already a physical activity. We often misunderstood that physical activities are just activities that makes us tired and exhausted. But often, then this activity should make us healthy. Yes. So, meron tayong mga physical activities na healthy para sa atin, meron namang hindi. Okay? So, katulad ito, pagsasalita, physical activity na to dahil ginagalaw ko na yung aking bibig, ang aking mga kamay. Okay? Katulad nyo rin, habang kayo nagwawalis sa bahay, physical activity na yan. Alright? So, during a physical activity, it requires effort. With this effort that is being displayed during an activity, so this will determine whether it is moderate or vigorous physical activity. Kasi dalawa po yan, no? Okay, so let us consider MET, or what we call metabolic equivalent. So, to measure of the exercise's intensity based on oxygen consumption. More specifically, a single MET is defined as the amount of oxygen a person consumes per unit of body weight during a minute. So, it is equal to about 3.5 milliliters of oxygen consumption per kilogram of the body weight per minute. Okay, so ayan. So, as you can see, the metabolic equivalent of task or MET is the objective measure of the ratio at which a person expends energy relative to the mass of that person while performing some specific physical activity. Oh, diba? Sige, igalaw mo. Yes, igalaw mo. Alright. Now, let's look at some examples of moderate intensity exercises and vigorous intensity exercises. So, let's go first in here. Moderate muna tayo. So, examples are brisk walking, dancing, gardening, housework or domestic chores. Moderate lang yan, ha? Hindi kayo masyadong pagod, hindi kayo masyadong hihingalin sa mga yan. What else? Traditional hunting or gathering. Active involvement in games and sports with children. Yung halimbawa, nagtatakbuhan kayo, naghaharutan kayo, yan. And walking domestic animals, yung nilalakad mo, pinapasyal mo yung dogs mo or any pet mo. And then, general building tasks such as roofing, thatching, painting, and carrying or moving moderate loads. Yung pagbubuhat ng hindi tataas sa 20 kilograms. Or depende sa weight mo kasi. Okay, so those are moderate intensity physical activities. How about vigorous? Ito yung medyo tataas na yung amount ng iyong breathing or yung pagbilis ng tibok ng puso mo. hindi lang bibilis ang tibok ng puso mo kapag may ano surprise test. No? Or kapag may LTO. Hindi. Dahil din sa vigorous or Vigorous intensity physical activities. Okay, examples. Running, walking or climbing briskly up a hill, fast cycling, aerobics, Zumba Zumba, fast swimming. Oo nga, no? Kaya pag nag-swimming tayo, yung parang nag-ano ka pa lang. Yung parang nagwa-warm up ka pa lang, pero hingal ka na. Competitive sports and games, such as yung mga traditional games na yan. Wala naman tayong football masyado. Or yan, volleyball and basketball ang kadalasang laro ng mga kabataan. And then, heavy shoveling or digging ditches. And carrying heavy loads greater than 20 kilograms. Yan. Yan yung mga vigorous intensity physical activities. Okay. So, andito yung mga pictures ng mga at-home activities natin na kung saan makikita ninyo kung ilan ang calories na mabuburn natin per ano to activity. So, let's say, sweeping carpet. O yan, for 30 minutes, yan, makakaburn tayo ng 99 to 124 calories. Sa gardening, playing with your dog, di ba, or any pet, wash and wax the car, playing with kids, moving furniture. Okay, mas mataas ang calorie burn, giging vigorous yung physical activity. So, better for lighter workouts para sa beginners. Sports and leisure, ito yung mga activities. Volleyball, uy, golf, pang mayaman. Dancing, backpacking, basketball, and soccer. Ito talaga yung kinakailangan yung katawan mo is parang mababatak talaga sa pagod. Okay, so, nasa reflection na tayo. Diba? Ang bilis. Activities and reflection. So, just continue the phrase. I learned that. So, this is about our topic, okay? Moderate and vigorous physical activities. Activity 1. Crossword puzzle. So, direction. Find the following words in here. And then, encircle them. Pwedeng diagonal. Pwedeng horizontal or vertical. Yeah, may mga nakikita na ako dyan. Ayan, no? Napakadali. Okay, so that's good for 20 minutes. Activity 2. You will just identify if the statement pertains to moderate physical activity or vigorous physical activity. That's 10 items only. Activity 3, entitled, I Belong To. So, below are different physical activities that we do. Then, you will identify which of these activities fall in moderate intensity physical activity and vigorous physical activity. Activity 4, how intense are you? Perform one activity at a time and fill out the information needed. Note that you should rest for 10 to 15 minutes before performing another activity. So, let's say, yung stationary walking, 5 minutes mong gawin. And then, sagutan mo lang itong mga tanong. Sa module na rin kayo sasagot. So, describe mo lang, how are you feeling after walking for 5 minutes? And then, how is your breathing? How is your sweat? How is your talking ability? Hindi pa ba kayo masyadong hinihinga sa 5 minutes na naglakad kayo? Next is stationary brisk walking for 4 minutes. And then, 3 minutes stationary jogging and 3 minutes jumping jack. Ayan, ito yung pinaka nakakahingal, jumping jack. 3 minutes kang mag-jumping jack. So, hindi sinasabi dito na 100 times kailangan yung jumping jack mo. Basta 3 minutes siya. So, activity 5. Essay lang to. Read and answer the questions. Differentiate moderate intensity with vigorous intensity physical activity. What else? How do we maintain doing physical activities in this time of pandemic? Number 3, in your daily living, especially in this time of pandemic, what moderate physical activities have you done so far? You can enumerate them. 4, what vigorous physical activities you have done Enumerate also. And number five, is it important to know the type of activity, if it is moderate or vigorous physical activity? Explain. Rubrics for assessment is already provided in your learning activity sheets. And that's it. Thank you very much again for joining, watching, listening in my lecture video. And kung may question kayo, don't hesitate to ask, comment down below, or message me in Google Classroom. Thank you very much and see you again next time for our fourth week session. Bye-bye!